fine. Let us move to the next concept. Fine. Now, graphically, what does it imply? Graphically, how we can see this work done? Suppose on y-axis, you have force. Fine. So this is the value of the force, and this is the displacement along the direction of force. Fine. This is displacement along the direction of force, and the force is changing its magnitude like this. Okay. It goes from here to there. So you have started from point number one. This is point number one, and you went to point number two. Okay. Now at any moment, let's say you're talking about this particular point. At any moment, let's take a very small displacement. If I take a very small displacement, I'll get a strip whose width is dr. Fine. So this is a strip I'm talking about whose width is dr. So dr is the displacement. Okay. And let us say at this moment, this is the value of force. Let's say F. Fine. So this particular length, this length is F because on y coordinate it is F, and the width is dr because on x axis there is r. Fine. So F dr is nothing but area of strip, isn't it? It's an area of the strip. And if you integrate this, if you integrate this, what does it mean? You're going everywhere and drawing a strip. You're slowly and slowly moving, and you're drawing strip and summing it up. Fine. So when you sum the strip, you'll get what? This will be the total area. Fine. So the area under force and displacement along the direction of force will give you the work done. Okay. In thermodynamics, we have already seen such scenario. The area under PV graph for gas is work done. Fine. Similarly here, area under force and the displacement along the direction of force will give you the work done by the force. Okay. All of you clear about it? Type in yes or no. You have any doubts? Is this applicable when force and area are not, force and area? See, here there is, we are not taking that. Okay. Force and displacement. No, then this area will not represent. We are assuming that the displacement is in the direction of force here. Okay. Otherwise, what will happen? There will be a term of cos theta also comes in. F dr cos theta will come. Now, this integral is not the area of the graph between F and R. Okay. Now, even though force is variable or force is a constant, it doesn't matter. Area under force and displacement along the direction of force will always give you the work done. Okay. And at times, force can be negative also. It can be like this. Then what you have to do? You have to find this area and subtract that area from it. Fine. Just like what we did for PV graph. This is negative force, right? From here till here, this force is negative. It means the force is against the direction of displacement. Okay, let us take a question on whatever we have learned till now. Fine. So here goes the question. All of you, please listen. A woman pushes a truck on a railway platform. Okay, there is a woman that pushes a truck on a railway platform which has a rough surface. Okay. She applies a force. The woman applies a force of 100 Newton over a distance of, see, the woman applies a force of 100 Newton over a distance of 10 meters. Okay. Thereafter, she gets progressively tired. After she applies a constant force of 100 Newton for 10 meters, she got tired and her applied force reduces linearly with distance. So the force after 10 meters reduces linearly with distance. Okay. And it reduces to 50 Newton linearly. Okay. The total distance through which the truck has moved is 20 meter. So total displacement is 20 meters. Okay. 10 meter is with the constant force and rest 10 meter is with this variable force that reduces linearly with the distance to 50 Newtons. Okay. You need to plot a graph between force versus plot a graph between force versus displacement. Let's say displacement is on the x-axis. Okay, find out. Sukir, that is wrong answer. Find out the plot the graph between force and displacement. Sukir, you don't need to hurry up every time. Okay, focus on the learning. Plot the graph first. Done. See, till the displacement is 10 meters. Let's say this is 10 meters. Okay. 20 meters. Okay. So till the displacement is 10, a constant force is applied, right? So let us say this is the force. This coordinate is 100 Newtons. Okay. Then this will be 50 Newton, half of the distance. So if you draw this line, this represents 50 Newtons, right? And we know that linearly the force has reduced from 100 Newton till 50 Newtons, right? So this point represents 50 Newton. And since it is linear reduction, the graph will be like this. Okay. So I hope all of you got this graph. Okay. Now find out the work done. Work done by the lady will be nothing but area of versus displacement graph, right? So if you are able to find this area, that is the answer. Okay, you can divide this entire area into two parts, a trapezium and a rectangle. Fine. So you can get area as 100 into 10, which is still 10 meters, and then half into sum of parallel sides, which is 100 plus 50 into distance between them, which is 10. Okay. this will come out to be 1750 newtons. Sorry, again and again, I'm taking it as newton. The unit says joules. Laws of motion chapter is still in our heads. Okay, this is what you'll get. Any doubts on whatever we have done till now? Please ask. Any doubts? Yes or no? All right, guys. So we have discussed about the work in greater detail. Okay. Now let's talk about energy. Now, energy is the capacity to do the work. All right. Now, you will be knowing many energies. Okay. There will be multiple types of energy. There will be sound energy. There will be light energy. There will be kinetic energy, potential energy. There will be, many spring potential energy, gravitational potential energy. Okay, there will be multiple types of energies that are there. Okay, our focus when we are doing this chapter is okay. So we are dealing with mechanical energy, fine. And there are only two kinds of mechanical energy. One is kinetic energy and the other is potential energy. Okay, potential energy is usually represented by a letter capital U, and kinetic energy is represented by a letter of capital K. Straightforward, right? Now, potential energy is the outcome of the force only. So we can leave this potential energy for some time. Okay, let us first only talk about kinetic energy, right? And I mean, there is no surprises here. Kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Okay, this is how we write kinetic energy. Okay, now this kinetic energy, we have written, this is the kinetic energy of a single mass moving with a speed v. Okay, speed is equal to the magnitude of instantaneous velocity at that moment. Okay, fine. Don't message unnecessary comments. If you have any doubts, then please message. Fine. So kinetic energy is half mv square, where m is in kgs, v is in meter per second. Okay, so this is the kinetic energy that we are dealing with. This will be in joules, right? Now, energy is capacity to do the work. Okay, now if I get some relation between how much energy is required to do what amount of work, then I can plan accordingly, right? I'll be exactly knowing what is the energy that is required to do this much amount of work, right? So we have learned about the work done separately. Okay, with the formula of our work done, we have taken different and we have solved problems to find the work. Okay, anything which you can create. All right, now energy is something which you can convert also. One form of energy can be converted into another form of energy. So energy also we have introduced here. This is the kinetic energy. Now we are going to learn what is the relation between the kinetic energy and the work done by the forces. Okay. So this relation is very important. Almost every numerical from this chapter will be solved from this particular relation that we are going to derive right now. Okay, so we'll take up different cases. Case number one is constant force. Okay, so for a constant force, acceleration is constant. Okay, so I will be able to write v square equals to u square plus 2a dot s. I'll be able to write down this. Okay, now if I multiply this entire thing with m by 2, what will I get? I'll get half mv square is equal to half mu square plus ma dot with displacement s. Okay, now see, left hand side is what? This is kinetic energy finally. Let's call it as K2. Okay. And this is what? Kinetic energy initially. Let's call it K1. Okay. And what is M into A? M into A, according to Newton's second law, should be equal to sum of all the forces. Right. So if you rearrange the terms, you'll be able to write down this as sum of all forces dot with displacement. Okay, this is equal to K2 minus K1, which is what? Change in kinetic energy. All right, now sum of all forces, you can write down it as F1 plus F2 plus F3, you know, like this, you can keep on writing depending on how many forces are acting on it, dot with S. This is equal to change in kinetic energy. Fine. Now let's open the brackets. If you open the brackets, you'll get F1 dot with S plus F2 dot with S plus F3 dot with S. Like this, if you keep on doing, you'll be adding it up, and then that is equal to change in kinetic energy. All right. Now tell me, what is F1 dot S? What it is? What it is? Correct. F1 dot S is the work done by F1 force. Fine. F2 dot S is work done by F2 force, and so on. If you add up all the forces, sorry, all the work done, that will be equal to change in kinetic energy. Okay, so basically work done by all the forces. This is total work done. Total work done on a block of mass M will be equal to change in kinetic energy. K2 minus K1. Fine. Write down this. You just individually take all the forces. One by one, you take all the forces, find out work done by all the forces. Okay. And add it up. You'll get total work done. That total work done should be equal to change in kinetic energy. Okay. This is also called as work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. Fine. Any doubt on this? This is the heart of the chapter. Any doubt? You can notice here one thing, that potential energy is not there in the expression. Okay. Fine. So we will later on introduce the potential energy. Right now, when you talk about gravity force, okay, you don't take gravitation potential energy. What you'll do, you'll find out the work done by gravity also. Once you define gravitation potential energy, then you will not take work done by gravity. Okay, so let's keep that aside. All right, I'm not assuming that you know anything which is potential energy. Okay, so potential energy is something which we will talk later. Right now, the theorem is plain and simple. Work done by all the forces will be equal to change in kinetic energy. Okay, and this is the case we have discussed for a constant force. Okay, now if force is variable, then what will happen? Let's take case number two. Case two is variable force. Okay. Now, kinetic energy is given as half m into v square. Fine. This is the kinetic energy. This is how kinetic energy is defined. All right. Now, if mass is constant, I'm assuming mass is constant when you're applying variable force. Okay. So if mass is constant and you differentiate kinetic energy, what you'll get? Dk by dt is equal to half m times 2v dv by dt. Okay, so this 2 is also gone. Fine. So you will get m into v, and what is dv by dt? Dv by dt is acceleration. Okay, so if you write it down, you'll get dk by dt. There'll be a dot product also coming in over here. Once you take it as vectors, this will be equal to m a dot with velocity. Okay, now the velocity you can write down in terms of displacement. It will be equal to rate of change of the position vector. Fine. Now you can cancel out dt from both sides. So you will get dk is equal to m into a. What is m into a? M into a is the force. Now this force is a variable, okay? Force is not constant. It continuously changes. So if you just take it as F, and this is dot dr. Now if you integrate, you'll see that this color, this side is what work done, right? And that side, you will go from K1 to K2. So that side will become delta K. Fine. So again, you are getting the same thing. Work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. The work energy theorem does not depend on whether you are having constant force or a variable force. If you are finding total work done, that total work done will be equal to change in kinetic energy, be it constant force or a variable force. Fine. Any doubts till now? Type in yes or no. Okay, great. Good to see you guys are clear about the concept. I hope you'll be as clear when you solve the numericals. No doubts.